Lord set a time and said, tomorrow the Lord will do this in the land. And the next day the Lord did it on the livestock of Egyptians died, but not one animal belonging to the Israelites died. The Pharaoh sent men to investigate and found that not even one of the animals the Israelites had died. And his heart was unyielding, and he would not let the people go. And the Lord said to Moses and Aaron, take handfuls of soot from the furnace and Moses tossed it into the air in the presence of Pharaoh. It will become fine dust of the land of Egypt. And the festival bonds will break out on the land and will serve the land. So they took soot from the furnace and stood before the Pharaoh. Moses tossed it into the air. Festering bones broke. I'm scared. The magicians could not stand before Moses because of the bulls that were on all the Egyptians, but the Lord hardened Pharaoh's heart, and he would listen to Moses and Aaron, just as the Lord had said to Moses. Said to Moses, get up early in the morning before the Pharaoh and say to him, this is what the Lord, the God of the Hebrews say, let my people go so that they may worship me. For this time I will send the full force of my plagues against you and against your officials and your people, so you may know that there is no one like me in all the earth. For by now I could have stretched out my hand and struck you and your people with the plague that would have wiped you off the earth. But I have raised you up for this very purpose, that I may show you my power and that my name will be proclaimed in all the earth. You still set yourself against my people and will not let them go. Therefore, at this time tomorrow, I will send the worst that has ever fallen on Egypt. From the day it was founded till now, give an order now to bring the livestock and everything you have in the field to a place of shelter, because the hail will fall on every man and animal that has not been brought in and is still out in the field, and they will die, those officials of Pharaoh who fear the word of the Lord, ready to bring their slaves and the livestock inside. So that none of the word of God that their slaves and livestock in the field. And the Lord said to Moses, stretch out your hand toward the sky that the hail would fall all over Egypt, on men and animals and everything on them. In the fields of Egypt, and Moses stretched out his staff toward the sky that would set. The field of the hail would lead up first hill to the waters. reading.I. Boy, this pharaoh's something else, man. Okay, thanks you guys. It's getting dark out, so I'm gonna be leaving. Thumbs up. Thank you. And subscribe and share.